Hey, bad buddies.
Paul Roberts, RT1 here.
So I had given out my last bat buckle. The reason is the mold had deteriorated. We're looking at almost 20 years and a lot of runs. A lot of runs of resin. It heats up, causes it to deteriorate. So I'm going to make another mold. All this time, people have asked me to make molds and show how it's done. But there's no difference in making a mold for a Batman thing over making a mold for anything. But because we have to do things for the table series, I'm gonna film it. So here we have a lot of things. I've got a lot more things in these boxes back here. I'm looking through all my other molds. I've got tons of things that I've never even done anything with, that I've had for decades. And never did anything with it. Real stuff from the actual movie props. So what makes me decide if I'm gonna do something? Well, the main thing is, if I'm gonna use it for my costuming hobby, I'll make it. And then when I've got it, I'll say, well, I've got it. As I'm making other stuff, can you use it? That's how I do it, because there's not enough incentive to do it. The hobby's just too small. And now, 20 years later, it's so fragmented, it's not funny. I was gonna make something because I wanted to try out a new technique. So my friend Alfred, you may know him by, gave me some advice. He said, go ahead and make something that you would use anyway. That way you're not wasting your time. And I agree. Almost everything I've ever made, I'm making anyway. So I made this bat buckle for my costume, my comic costume, for my muscle suit. It needed to be about the size of a comic Batman. I made a key of it. Notice it's flat. This one has been sitting a long time and it's gone flat, but generally they're rounded. What I do is I make the mold flat, pour it up, and then I curve it and I let it cure in the curved position. That way I have the option to do it flat if I want to, or the other buckle that I do that I made out of the same thing that's curved around the edges, you've got a curve to it. But what happened here is I created this additional way of looking from this other one, out of a curved one. Again, a lot of times I'll do something because I can, but I don't generally do things to sell. If I do sell something, it's because I'm doing it anyway, normally. There are exceptions, but normally that's the way I work. So don't write to me and say, can you make that? The answer will be no, and here's why. The answer is no, because nobody wants to pay for all the processes necessary for one element. So the reason why I haven't made certain things is because there aren't enough people that would want it to warrant the process. So I haven't done it. I just hang on to it, say, well, maybe one day. Because what you'd have to do is, I've got my silicone over here, and I've got my various things, and I've got all my other stuff that's in here and different other places in the cave that I hadn't even gotten out. And the reason this stuff is out is that I was looking for this, and it was in this box, so I knew I had to get this stuff out. I just figured I'd look at it while I had it out. The reason why I don't make something, if someone says, can you make me this, is because you'd have to pay for the material, pay for the time to get the thing up to speed, really looking good, making sure all the flaws are out of it. You have to pay for all the time molding it and everything like that, cleaning up the mold, doing all that stuff. And then, only then, when I do the last step, where I take my time to put resin, clean it up, paint it, fabricate it, and offer it. If you take all those other things that it took to get to that last step, the price to do anything is just really, for us and our purposes, just ridiculously high to justify my time and expenses. So I just don't push for it. Anyway, that's what that is. This is about getting ready to mold something. The next video will be about the molding of it. And you can see it anywhere you want. I'll not teach you probably anything new, but I'm gonna do it because people would like me to. People have been asking me. And there's nothing secretive about it. You can find out how to do a simple silicone mold in a million different places. But I'm gonna do it here too. So that'll be the next video. And there's a number of other things that I'm also going to do. Like some glove fins that I have here. One of the molds deteriorated for that. A mummy key. One of the molds is on its last legs for that. Hardly anybody asks for it. But since it's so simple to do it, and it's a small element, I'm just gonna process it all together and do it. But this one I'm gonna do all by itself. So let's get ready to start that video. Oh, there's gonna be another video soon. That's gonna be more about myself and looking back at my past, and I'll have that up soon. That'll have nothing to do with the Bat Buddies. But if you're interested in finding out how to do a basic mold, I will do that in the next video. And that's our video for today. Keep the comments coming. if you don't make it fun, what's the point of me doing it? I can just sit here and work and not talk about what I'm doing instead, like I've done for 20 years. All right, bad buddies, I'm Paul Roberts, Artsy One, and that's it for today.